So to restart Windows Update Service, we have to type services.msc in the run box and then open the services.msc. Once services.msc is open, we have to click on any of the service and then click on the W. It will take you to the services starting with W and you will find a Windows Update Service over there. So to restart the Windows Update Service, you can restart it with many ways. You can right click and then stop it and then again start the service, or you can right click the service or restart it directly. Third way would be, you can select the service and on the left side you can restart the service from the restart the service option. Now we are going to see how to restart the service with a command. Open the command prompt with the cmd command from the run box and type net space stop space w-a-u-s-e-r-v and then hit enter. If you find this error, means you have not opened command prompt with the administrative rights. So again, in the search box, type the command, that is cmd, and once you find the command prompt application, open the command prompt with a run as administrator. Click yes on the user account control permissions and then it will open the command prompt with the administrative rights. Again, type command net space stop space w-a-u-s-e-r-v and then it will stop the service, and to start the service you can type net space start space w-a-u-s-e-r-v and then you can check if your issue is resolved or not.
I would try with the dism.exe, and to try this out you have to open command prompt with the administrator rights and then type this command. What, so this is the command to clean up the image and restore the health, and with the help of this command you will be able to resolve this issue in a quicker way. So dism.exe/online/cleanup-image/restore-health is a command, and for me it was a failure to run this command and I got the error, and I am trying now another step, that is Windows Update Troubleshooter, and I'm going to run the troubleshooter. Windows Update Troubleshooter will do one thing, that is will check the Windows Update database if it is corrupt or not. If it is corrupt, it will try to replace it and it will create a new folder, that is software distribution folder in the Windows. So software distribution folder is used for collecting and downloading all the patches onto your computer and then it installs from there. So that is what this step is going to do. It will check if the software distribution folder contents are good, if the database is good, and then it will try to fix the issue. If the Windows database is corrupt, it will create a new folder as software distribution.bak and restart the services and restart all the services like Windows Update Service, Bit Service, Cryptographic Service and Installer Service. So this will restart all the services and try to fix the issue. For me, running the troubleshooter helps me out and fix the